Team, and it's about the client and the case, and all pieces fit together here. And so, obviously, thank Jessica and Max, who is instrumental. Also, Myra, who is the paralegal on this case, did a fantastic job. So, thanks to the team. Family obviously is so important in each of our own successes, and for me, it's really a gift to have a dad, growing up with dad, with trial attorney, and be able to trial strategy with him when I needed the most, and a mother who's a therapist to deal with my psychosis when I'm a child. So, probably leaned on my mother more than my father. And of course, my wife who's here tonight, Sarah.
Yes, Sarah.
I can't tell you how many nights I would come home, whether it be this trial or others, where I'm just exhausted and have nothing else to say but trying to explain to her what happened in trial. And she's like, you realize you have a 2-year-old daughter, right? Like, oh, thanks for taking care of her while I've been in trial for the last month. So I really appreciate everything that you have done for me and helping me be who I am, and allowing me to help the clients that we've been able to help. Without you, I don't think I would ever be able to do it. So thank you. You know, I tried to think about what I took away from this particular trial, and you know, what was the lesson learned in the trial. And I think about really three things. One was, resilience. This trial came off the heels of a trial that Jessica and I had tried with John. And it was a long, hard-fought battle against Caltrans in Los Angeles on a roadway design case. Little boy who was catastrophically injured. And we poured our blood, sweat, and tears and our heart into this case for this boy and this family. And we came up short. And it was devastating, just absolutely devastating, because we did everything we believed we could and thought we had it. And then what do you do? You know, do you crawl up into a hole, which is frankly what I felt like doing, or do you get back up? And in this trial, it came probably not even 2 months after that. You have to get back up, and I realized, you know, the next client needs us just as much as the last client. And if we, you know, cave or cower the fear of not being able to be successful, then, you know, we're probably in the wrong business. And we got back up and we fought a really hard fight. And so, you know, I recognize that all of us lose and all of us have defeat, but what makes us trial lawyers is the fact that we get back up and we do it again. Woo! And so that is a lesson. You know, another lesson I felt that I learned in this case is the importance of credibility. You know, we're not Jessica, Max, and I, we're not probably the flashiest or the most articulate or dynamic, and we fumble all the time. But at the end of the day, we told a truthful story. You know, in the case you heard with Araceli, you know, there was another person involved who dropped the ladder, and we could have tried to fight it and say, well, he's not at fault, but we settled with the guy. So how are we gonna sit there and say he's not responsible? So we owned it, and we, every step of the way we fought, but we conceded where we needed to concede, and I believe that's an important part of being a trial lawyer, is recognizing where you need to concede and being credible, and I thought that was really what did it for us, and our client was credible the whole way through. And the third thing that I learned in this trial was the importance of just being yourself. Again, we are who we are, and we didn't try to put on an act. And most importantly, we did not make our client try to put on an act. She was somebody who did not feel comfortable at the end of the day testifying in English. And as you heard her on the video, she can speak English, but she didn't feel like she could convey her story effectively in English. And I didn't know that she felt that way until right before she testified, literally the morning of. She said, "What should I do?" I said, "You should then get an interpreter. I'm not worried about it. You need to be able to tell your story how you feel most comfortable. And I'm not gonna let you do something you don't feel comfortable about just because I'm afraid of somebody prejudicing you because of how they feel." And at the end of the day, I'm very happy we did, because she shared very compelling stories. And at the end of the day, the reason the jury gave her every penny is because of her. Because she was truthful, credible, and she told her story honestly and herself. And so I'd like to, you know, recognize that for her and for everybody here. Is I hope we can all just be ourselves and recognize that at the end of the day, it's about justice and it's about truth. And so I want to thank CASD for this wonderful, wonderful recognition. I feel very inadequate, honestly, up here with the other awardee recipients. Maybe I'll borrow some of Darush's cash from his cell and put it to mine, and we'll be good. But at the end of the day, I'm really appreciative. Thank you to CASD for this honor, and thank you to all of Gomez, the trial attorneys, and John Gomez for being on this podcast. Thank you.